Hello students, in this video I will be discussing about orthogonal complements. Now, if we consider a vector V in a vector space V with a defined inner product, the orthogonal complement of V denoted by V with a perpendicular sign, and it is read as V perp. Now, this V perp is a set of all vectors in V which are orthogonal to V. Now, if we have W equal to say V1, V2, V3, Vn, we can write W per to be vectors in, now this is a subset of the inner product space V. So the orthogonal complement of the set W will be vectors of V such that U is orthogonal to each vector of V where Vi belongs to W for each I. Now, to understand this, let us consider an example. V equal to 1, 2, minus 1, 3. The orthogonal complement. Find the orthogonal complement V perp. For that, we have the definition of V perp to be the set of all vectors of V such that inner product of the those vectors with V is zero. So let U equal to X, Y, Z and T belongs to V perp. Now we consider the element in R4 because V is an element in R4. Now U belongs to V perp. This implies inner product of UV should be equal to 0. So we have the, since R, we have R4, it is the usual inner product. So X into 1 plus Y into 2 plus Z into minus 1 plus T into 3 equal to 0. That is X plus 2Y minus Z plus 3T equal to 0. There is only one equation and four unknowns. That means rank is 1 and the number of free variables will be 3. So we take Y equal to A, Z equal to B, T equal to C as the arbitrary values. So we end up with X equal to minus 2A plus B minus 3C. So if we write this in form of a vector, that is we write it in the form of a column matrix to give minus 2A plus B minus 3C, A, B, C. Now we'll write this as a linear combination of three independent vectors. So we collect the coefficients of A, B, and C. So this will be minus 2, 1, 0, and 0. Now the coefficients of B are 1, 0, 1, 0. Coefficients C are minus 3, 0, 0, 1. So we have any linear combination of any vector that is a linear combination of these three vectors will belong to the orthogonal complement of the vector 1, 2, minus 1, 3. In fact, these three being independent vectors, they form the basis of the orthogonal complement of V. So we write the basis of V per to be minus 2, 1, 0, 0, 1, 0, 1, 0, minus 3, 0, 0, 1. Or V perp is equal to span of minus 2, 1, 0, 0, 1, 0, 1, 0, minus 3, 0, 0, 1. Now suppose we consider a polynomial space P2 of T. This is inner product space of all polynomials of degree less than or equal to 2. The inner product defined is inner product of fg is integral 0 to 1 f of t g of t dt, and we have say p of t equal to 2t plus 1. Let us find the orthogonal complement of p of t. Now orthogonal complement of P of T would be, now since we are talking about inner product space of polynomials of degree less than or equal to 2, let us consider that to be of the form AT squared plus BT plus C, such that this we can give it as say Q of T, which is of the form, which is a quadratic polynomial. Now inner product of PQ should be equal to 0. Therefore the inner product of PQ, this is integral 0 to 1 at squared plus 2t plus 1 into, this is bt plus c into 2t plus 1 dt, which is integral 0 to 1 2at cube plus 2b t squared plus b plus 2c into t plus c dt. integrating, we get a by 2 t power 4 plus a plus 2b by 3 t cube plus b plus 2c by 2 t squared plus ct from 0 to 1, which will give us a by 2 plus a plus 2b by 3 plus b plus 2c by 2 plus c. Simplifying this, we have five a plus 7b plus this will be 6 plus 6, 12c. Since the inner product is 0, if we equate inner product equal to 0, we get 5a plus 7b plus 12c equal to 0. Now, since we have the rank to be 1, but 3 unknowns, the solution space will be of dimension 3 minus 1, that is 2, and therefore we need 2 polynomials which will be the basis for the orthogonal complement of the polynomial P of t. So we can choose arbitrary variables here. For convenience, we know that we require 2 independent vectors or 2 independent polynomials. Therefore, we can give two sets of arbitrary values for b and c, preferably multiples of 5. So if we choose b equal to 5 and c equal to 0, we get 5a plus 35 equal to 0, which results in a equal to minus 7. So we have q1 of t to be minus 7 t squared plus 5t. Similarly, if we substitute b equal to 0, c equal to 5, this results in 5a plus 6t equal to 0, so a equal to minus 12. So q2 of t equal to minus 12t squared plus 5. So the orthogonal complement of P of t will be span of q1 of t, q2 of t. In fact, since these two polynomials are independent, they will form the basis. So basis of orthogonal complement of P will be q1 of t and q2 of t. In this question, we will add an additional condition for the solution. In the previous two problems, we found the basis for the orthogonal complement. So we will add a condition that the basis that we find has to be orthogonal to each other. So the definition we require vectors of R4. Since W belongs to R4, we have W perp also in R4. So inner product of W with U will be 0 for orthogonality. Now let U equal to X, Y, Z and T belong to W perp. In fact, we will say U belongs to orthogonal basis of W perp, which is a subset of W perp. Therefore, we get X minus 2y minus z plus 3t equal to 0. We require, since rank is 1, because we have only one equation, n equal to 4, the number of unknowns, dimension of W perp will be n minus r, because W perp is in fact now the solution space of this equation, so we should have dimension of the solution space to be n minus r, which is equal to 3. Now this is r. So to begin with, if we consider, now for convenience, we need to take arbitrary values for y, z and t. Now for convenience, we can choose values of y, z and t such that x equal to 0. Let the arbitrary value be y equal to 1, z equal to 1, t equal to 1. This implies x minus 2 minus 1 plus 3 equal to 0, which gives us x equal to 0. So we'll call u1 equal to 0, 1, 1, 1. Now we have the first element of the orthogonal basis of W. Now since we want the basis to be an orthogonal basis, now we need to ensure that U is orthogonal to W as well as U is orthogonal to U1. That is, we need two more vectors. To form orthogonal basis, now this choice of y, z and t was only for convenience, so that in the second step we don't need to perform the echelon form. So because of these two conditions, the first equation will remain as it is. Now the inner product of u with u1 will result in y plus z plus t equal to 0. As you can observe, if we write the matrix, coefficient matrix of this system, it will be already in the echelon form because of our choice of y, z and t. So here rank is equal to 2. So we substitute arbitrary values for y and z. Say in this we have one more step to do, so we can choose any value for z and t. If we choose z equal to 1 or z equal to minus 1 and t equal to minus 1, this will give us y equal to 0. Substituting that in x, we get y minus 0, minus 1, minus 3 equal to 0. So we have x equal to 4. So we'll denote the second vector that we have got, that is 4, 0, 1 and minus 1. So we have two vectors now for the orthogonal basis of W. So one more step and we would have the required three vectors to form the orthogonal basis of W per. So for that, we consider again inner product of U, W equal to 0, inner product of U, U1 equal to 0, inner product of U, U2 equal to 0. So once we find this vector U, that we can denote it as U3, and that would complete the set for orthogonal basis of W perp. So we have the first equation will be a first and second equation we already have. So x minus 2y minus z plus 3t equal to 0, y plus z plus t equal to 0, and because of the fourth, the third, the second point that we found, 4, 0, 1, minus 1, the inner product of u with u2 will result in 4x plus z minus t equal to 0. So this will give us the coefficient matrix to be 1, minus 2, minus 1, 3, 0, 1, 1, 1, 4, 0, 1, minus 1. Now if we reduce, if we apply the row transformations on this coefficient matrix, we get 0, 1, 1, 0, 8, 5 minus 13, which further simplifies to 1 minus 2 minus 1, 3, 0, 1, 1, 1, 0, 0, minus 3, minus 21. So x minus 2y minus z plus 3t equal to 0, y plus z plus t equal to 0, minus 3z minus 21t equal to 0. If we take t equal to 1, this implies we get z equal to minus 7. So y minus 7 plus 1 equal to 0 implies y equal to 6. X minus 12 plus 7 plus 3 equal to 0 implies x equal to 2. So we get the vector that we have got, we will denote it as U3. So that is 2, 6, minus 7 and 1. Now in the previous problems, we just found a basis for the orthogonal complement. But in this vector, in this problem, we have ensured that the basis U1, U2, U3 are orthogonal to each other. So we have orthogonal basis of W per to be zero, one, 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 four, zero, one, minus one, and two, six, minus seven, one.